Welcome back to Beyond Words. I'm Mark Hart. This Sunday, the Gospel of St. Matthew is going to prepare us for the next several Sundays, because the next few Sundays, you're going to see a trend happen. Through Matthew's Gospel, you're going to see the trend of the parables coming to light. Now, if you, like me, live in the suburbs in America in the 21st century, and you're not necessarily very familiar with agricultural terms or with trees or with seeds and things like that, at first glance, some of these parables might throw us. This is why it's so important to have a good study Bible, to open up to the Gospel on your own. Open up to Matthew 13 this week. Open up the Gospel each week. Read for yourself the footnotes. Get yourself a good commentary. Read the commentary. It's amazing how much depth is there. It's amazing how much truth comes to life when we put in a little bit of effort and let the church in her wisdom guide us through the saints, through trusted authors, through people who really know their stuff. This week, however, we're given a gift because the church in her wisdom and the Holy Spirit in his intentionality give us one of the easier parables, one of the most famous parables, the parable of the sower and the seed. And we go on to hear the parable, you've heard it many times before, I'm sure, that the word of God is the seed and it's going to get cast out. Now, some of it's going to fall on the path, some of it's going to fall on rocky ground, some of it's going to fall on shallow soil, some of it's going to fall among thorns, and some of the seed's going to fall on rich soil. And we know these analogies, right? Some the stuff that falls in the path is going to get swept away by birds, okay? And the stuff that falls in the rocky soil is going to have, you know, no chance at life. It's going to have no water, no roots. The stuff that falls in the shallow soil, that seed, it's going to be beaten down by the sun. It's not going to have roots. It's going to wither and die. The seed that falls among the thorns is going to be suffocated. It's not going to even have a chance at life. And then lastly, the rich soil. It's actually going to get deep roots, bear great fruit from now for eternity, for a long, long time. Now, my brothers and my sisters, here's the question. Many of us hear this parable and we say to ourselves, oh, I'm the rich soil. I received the word of God and absolutely, I am the rich soil. Sometimes we are, sometimes not so much. In fact, at any different part of our life or our faith journey, we're probably any variety of soil. There's times that we're fickle. There's times that we are emotional in our response to God, but we don't actually do the work, develop a prayer life, develop roots. There's times that we're swept away by emotionalism, swept away by the world, swept away by the evil one, and by our own sin and our own temptations. There's times that we fail to just develop those roots. My brothers and my sisters, if we are to live as Christians, if we're to live as Catholics in today's culture, we have to be rooted in Christ. We have to plant our roots in Christ. My brothers and my sisters, we have to have that daily rhythm, that daily relationship. We have to have the sacraments to help us to grow and to bear fruit. How will you know a true Catholic, a true Christian? You shall know him or her by the fruit that they bear. May God bless you this week.
More shows can be seen on Faith and Life Television at faithandlifetv.com.